Lineker, Andrade 2.
4 months we've been waiting on this.
John Lineker immediately closing that distance, looking to put those hands to good use as he's attacking the body of Andrade. Let's see if Andrade can figure out this puzzle that is John Lineker chopping down the legs.
Trading leg kicks, left to the body from Lineker.
Takedown, but Fabricio popping right back up to his feet. Lineker hanging on him. I like this early mix-in of the takedowns, Rich.
Yeah, this is what I was talking about because, you know, in the first match, Lineker basically depended on the takedown when he had to, but this time he's throwing those takedowns, and this is going to keep Andrade guessing so that he doesn't know whether he's throwing the punch or closing the distance for the takedown.
Beautiful little belly-to-back suplex right there, but Fabricio popping right back up onto his feet. Nice little drop down, attack the legs, but Fabricio's so hard to hold down as Lineker starts to let the hands go.
Lineker firing hooks into the body of Andrade.
Lineker wobbled right there in the corner. You saw Andrade's knees just buckle.
Look at Lineker.
And now Lineker just got wobbled.
Lineker unloading and then that stiff jab to the face of Andrade.
Andrade is doing a good job of utilizing that lateral footwork on his back foot. As he narrowly misses with an elbow attempt there. Lineker continues to push forward.
Andrade waiting for the knee, couldn't land it. Lineker counters back with a right.
You can definitely see the adjustments that Lineker has made in this match now. He's got Andrade thinking more. He's not completely in control, given it's still early in the first round, but definitely some good adjustments he's made.
Lineker cutting down the angles in the opening couple of minutes. Taking to the body of Andrade. Andrade with a low kick to answer, and then the body kick blocked by Lineker.
Yeah, but using the legs is going to be important for Andrade.
Right, and then the takedown again in the corner by Lineker. But quickly back to his feet again is Andrade.
Trying to go for the
unloading rights. Yeah, Lineker unloading rights, trying to get him count. Andrade sprawling. Can't let it go with a right and then a right knee. And a knee counterattack from Andrade.
I think we're seeing the strength of Lineker here on display, but he's got to be careful here because this kind of pace, when you're coming in explosively like that and then using that static hold kind of pressure, it can wear you down.
But Lineker's a vet, Rich. He's been in there a long time with some of the very best in the world. He knows what he needs to do to come into this match in shape to go 5 hard rounds. And you said it yourself, he expects to go into deep water with Andrade.
Agreed, but you saw that last overhand right that Lineker threw. I mean, everything that he does takes a lot of energy. Just stylistically, that's his style requires energy.
Chopping on that front leg is Andrade, and the front kick and a left.
Yeah, the front kick, throwing the toes to the solar plexus of Lineker. The body work of Andrade really paid dividends as the match wore on, just taking the wind out of Lineker slowly over time, and he needs to get back to that, utilizing those push kicks and those knees as Lineker tries to approach.
A lot of overhands from Lineker, and we saw that in the first fight as well, and a lot of that, of course, has to do with the size. The taller man is Andrade by a wide margin. There's a nice combination for Lineker on the way in.
Yeah, you see Lineker throwing those overhand rights, but getting his head offline while he's doing it, so he's making Andrade miss.
But Andrade didn't miss that knee.
No, he didn't.
Lineker did a good job of circling out on the first knee attempt, but now these knees are starting to connect. Lineker needs to get back to that movement. That's what he needs to do. He angled out immediately once he saw that knee coming. That's going to be pivotal to avoid those sharp, punishing knees of Andrade.
I didn't think about the challenge that Andrade has here in the ring because you have these 90-degree corners, and it's easier for Lineker to cut the corner and cut the ring off on him.
Oh, yeah, it makes a huge difference to trap Andrade in that corner. If he can pin him there and let go of some of those hooks, that could be the end of the night for Fabricio.
He's done it a couple times already.
Fabricio from Andrade there, 30 seconds to go, round one of 5, the bout judged as a whole.
Yeah, Brent, he's doing a good job of working underneath the chin of Lineker. Attacking the body, attacking the legs, trying to break Lineker down. But Lineker's just walking through a lot of these shots, but that right hand stuck.
Lineker, wow, he's in some trouble on his feet. Flying in for the knee.
Oh, that's it, he's on unsteady legs.
Andrade lands to the left.
He's hurt, he's hurt.
Round 2 begins, and the world title fight. And Lineker comes out of fire.
in a good spot. He does his best work punching people down. Trapping him in the corner and letting go of those hands. Oh, working the body of Andrade.
Ripping the body is Lineker. Opening 20 seconds have been good for Lineker after he was in some trouble to close the first. Shoots for the takedown. Andrade, good defense.
Yeah, that was a sloppy shot, Brent. He dropped down with his head. No setup on it. Lineker needs to set those up better if he wants to take down Fabricio.
Or even if he wants to fool him with the takedown.
Oh, nice jab by Andrade, but Lineker's using those leg kicks well. That'd be an important weapon if he can keep going back to those leg kicks.
1 minute into the second round of five, the world title in the bantamweight division. The rematch between these two, 4 months in the making.
I like the feints of Andrade. Getting a reaction out of Lineker, but Lineker shoots in, gets his hands below the hips. But Fabricio peeled up the hands. That was a really smart move to prevent Lineker from dropping down low.
Good hip work here. Wizard keep that pressure on, working the leg to the outside, defending the takedown.
Man, Fabricio's really hard to take down, and he's been able to get him down, but he can't keep him down, Rich.
This is the thing, you know, you guys were talking about this in the first round, all the takedowns. Me personally, I don't score those takedowns. Like, you have to not only take your opponent down, but maintain some sort of control position, at least for a given period of time.
He didn't control it fully there, but he unloaded some rights, did Lineker.
Drops down, puts the hands under the hips. Beautiful job by Andrade to fight the hands. He's got to get out this corner. He does.
Lineker throwing leather now back to the center of the ring. 3 minutes to go in round two. Overhand right from Lineker.
Lineker's wearing some damage on that nose. It's bothering him slightly, and it's coming from that jab.
The jab splitting the guard by Andrade. We've seen it a few times in this round. Combination there from Lineker on the attack again.
You know, Lineker let him off easy out of that corner last time because he's pretty much nullified Andrade's clinch work, because every time Andrade goes to the clinch, like that Muay Thai clinch, Lineker just goes downstairs to the body and starts throwing those heavy body shots.
Like how he's mixing in the leg work, chopping down those legs, taking out that support base of Andrade. But Andrade stinging him with that jab just over and over, touching him. Andrade's got Lineker on the back foot. That is not where Lineker wants to be.
You see the redness in the nose, some blood, a little bit on the face there of Lineker. He continues the jab on Andrade here. And a right, the counter right from Lineker, and then a left.
You know, initially Lineker was coming in and closing that distance, getting on the inside, but now he's kind of standing at range. He's gotten a little bit of success with the leg kicks, but this is that range where Fabricio was picking him apart with the jab last night. It was that range that made that shot kind of sloppy and gave Fabricio the ability to defend.
1-2 from Lineker, and then another left. Sending Andrade backwards.
Lineker slowed down a little bit.
Seconds here in round two.
One thing I'd like to see from Andrade, you see him just land that jab, he'll land another jab, but as he lands that jab, if he's not going to throw again, get out of range, angle off something so that he's not just standing in pocket, because he's taking unnecessary abuse from Lineker that he doesn't need to.
A lot of it's coming from that low leg kick coming from Lineker. I like that weapon. He needs to keep going back to it, but I'd like to see him set up with some hands, at least put a jab in front of it. Again, with the knee, this is Fabricio.
Lineker responding with left hooks. Left to the body, left to the face of Andrade. Andrade with a 1-2.
That right hand is a thing of beauty. Comes right down the pipe so fast, so accurate.
So
the two.
Straight.
So fast. Boom, boom, throws the knee, misses the knee. Beautiful circle out for Lineker to avoid the knee, but he got caught with the right hand.
Rich, how entertaining is this fight through almost two rounds?
Oh, this is beautiful because this is a nice back and forth action. I mean, I have Fabricio's in control of this match for the most part, but he, like I said before, he's taking this unnecessary damage, and that's not something you want to do against Lineker.
Andrade grew up as a kid, idolizing Lineker, watching all of his fights, and now he's got new respect for the man. It is bad blood between them.
10-second clapper goes as Lineker throws a two-punch combination. Fabricio trying to go up top, taking out these two, really putting on a show here in Lumpini Stadium, the iconic Lumpini Stadium.
That jab has been so effective and so powerful throughout the fight from Andrade.
I actually like when Lineker is using his jab. It's not something that we normally see from him, but he's popped that jab out right there. Jab landed, and it's really negating the forward movement from Fabricio in this match. There's another one.
Underrated weapons coming from Lineker are that jab and that low kick. Most of his knockouts are coming from those wide-angled hooks, but the jab and those low kicks help set up those shots. But Andrade, again, with those straight punches, that jab just working so well against the shorter John Lineker.
Into round three in his Bantamweight world title fight. Digging to the body again, Lineker.
Lineker in this round, he's really composed with his punch. He's not throwing so big that he's wasting energy, particularly when he misses and when they get blocked. Until the punches are coming in heavy, particularly the body shots, which is very composed with it.
One championship right here inside historic Lumpini Boxing Stadium. And putting on a show in this main event for these tremendous fans. Lineker and Andrade. A scramble there. Back to his feet is Andrade. And a left from Lineker.
Yeah, there's that. Any one of the adjustments that Lineker made going back to the corner was the utilization of that jab in this third round.
Definitely been a difference maker. I'm impressed with Fabricio. Like, Lineker's landed several 2-3-piece combinations, and Fabricio's just eating this stuff. And this is the guy they call Hands of Stone.
Yeah, and that's a clean left hook that Lineker landed, and Fabricio ate it like a delicious plate of pot thai.
He keeps coming forward, Andrade does, nearing the midpoint of this main event, world title fight.
Fabricio with that jab, just a trip hammer.
Triple jab that time.
And on that last jab, like, he landed that jab and then kind of lazily stayed there, and that allowed Lineker to return with the jab. And keep in mind, we're talking about Fabricio has a 5-inch reach advantage. Like, he should be able to hit that jab and disappear.
Side leg kick Lineker, and then he takes another jab to the face.
Yeah, but Fabricio saw that one coming. He was able to lean into it.
Fabricio peppering him with that snapping jab.
Lineker is just blocking all these jabs straight up with his face. Not the best defensive posture, but when you got a chin like Lineker, he's okay just to take one, just to be able to give one back. And there's that jab again, Rich.
Trading jabs. Good sequence here.
Man, this jam-packed arena is quiet. There's a hush has fallen over the crowd. They're used to seeing world-class strength, and they're getting another taste of it here today.
I want to remind you, when we were talking to Fabricio earlier this week, Brent, he said, what did he say? Inside three.
Inside of 3 minutes.
Inside of three.
Three rounds, I should say, yep.
I mean, after the success he had in the first fight, I think he's surprised that this match has gone this long, especially having Lineker on skates the way that he did in the second.
I'm sure. I'll just say this. The difference between the first match and the second match is I'm 100% certain that Lineker has earned Fabricio's respect at this point in time.
Oh, 100.
Final minute, third round. Big left from Lineker. Lineker with a 1-2.
The two connected, Brent. There's that knee right up the middle.
Step through from Andrade. 45 seconds.
Ooh, wow, that one hurt the eye. Fabricio winced ever so slightly as Lineker trying to put pause on Wonderboy. That's what I think Andrade needs to do, man. He needs to go to the body with those kicks. He needs to throw those knees. Right now he's getting a little boxing heavy. There's the knee.
Seconds. Heavy right, though, from Lineker on the counter.
Yeah, you can see Fabricio's right eye starting to close up over there.
Fabricio chopping away at the front leg of Lineker. Mixing levels, Lineker shoots.
Oh, that was telegraphed.
Lineker is back.
Beautifully timed from Fabricio to turn the corner and put Lineker on the back. That's a dominant way to end this round, Rich.
Yeah, it's just a great kind of matador style. Yeah. Missing that shot and ended up on top.
I like like the feints coming from Andrade here to open the fourth. Kind of freezing Lineker with some of these feints and then coming right down the middle with those 1-2s.
You know, one of the things coming into this was that in the first fight, we saw the best of Andrade as he takes a couple of shots here. Yeah, heavy artillery from Lineker.
That shot that took his balance, I think it just took his balance. It came over top of his head and threw him off balance. It didn't wobble him.
We saw the best of Andrade in the first fight. That was the theory, and we didn't from Lineker. And that's kind of being proven here in this rematch.
Yeah, Lineker talked about that. He talked about actually being stripped of his title and missing, and how that really psychologically took him out of the fight, and he just wasn't there. And he said, you haven't seen the best version of me, and I'm going to bring the best version of me. Now, whether or not this is the best version, I'll tell you what, this is definitely a Lineker 2.0 from the first fight for sure.
And that's talking about the reset that you documented in the open there, Mitch.
Yeah, I think that Lineker might not have taken Fabricio that seriously. He had a lot of hype and a lot of big knockouts, but he never really did it to a big-time opponent. And Lineker didn't really give Andrade the respect he deserved. And then to see him go back, make the adjustments necessary, refine the camp, and come out here with a performance like this against Andrade, who was basically just a one-sided butt-whooping, to be quite frank, in the first fight, it is really a true testament to what Lineker is all about.
3:15 to go in round four.
Stiff jab again, just touching, just scoring points is Andrade.
Yeah, I like the adjustments that Andrade's made in this round. He's doing a good job of doubling and tripling up the jabs. He got caught there coming out, but he's done a much better job of utilizing that jab and then and micro moving his way out, just like he did there without getting caught.
Beautiful combination. Andrade takes a heavy left. Andrade.
Every time Lineker lands one of those big punches, you see Fabrizio's head just snapping. I'm wincing over here.
He continues to stand and trade, though. 2.5 to go in the fourth.
A lot of feints coming from Andrade off that rear leg.
A low blow, which again, a low blow ended the first fight in a no contest.
Yeah, but Lineker told me he's packing steel.
Good.
He's packing steel, so he's well protected. Nothing's going to explode on him here today. But a little bit of a flashback right there for Lineker.
It might not be low. Let's see here. What do you think, Mitch?
Well, it definitely looked like he was below the belt line. I don't know if it could have been on the hip flexor or the groin. Not my call.
You know, from that angle, you don't know that maybe the knee actually hit above the belt line, but when the shin, sometimes the knee can flex and the shin come out and catch the cup.
The balance of Andrade on these takedown attempts of Lineker has been sensational throughout this fight. Oh, anyway, Lineker.
Yeah, we're seeing really good takedown defense from Andrade. His sprawls, his ability to see the takedowns coming. If Lineker wants to take Andrade down, he has to put hands in front of the takedown and then shoot in.
He needs to start getting some head movement in there just so he's not on line for these counters.
Lineker shoots again and then slipping out of it, Andrade once again.
That was better, but when he entered into the single leg, he didn't transition to another takedown because he was able to get the single, but he should have went to a double, turn the corner, attack a little bit more aggressively. But that's easy for me to say, sitting 20 feet away from the action.
90 seconds in round four.
Wide angled hook landed by Lineker as he followed it up with a two.
Oh, big knee, Andrade, then the body kick, and then the 1-2.
Straight right, left. Yeah, that left hand is a thing of beauty for Fabricio Andrade.
Yeah, and it cut Lineker open. He's got a cut above the right eye now on the eyebrow there with the bleeding.
Beautiful combinations again coming from Andrade. Counter to the left, Lineker, but he's taking heavy shots.
Andrade stinging him with that left hand as Lineker shoots in for another single, easily defended from Fabricio.
Blood coming from the nose and the right eye of John Lineker. Takes another heavy shot.
Lineker's hurt here. Lineker's hurt.
He's not seeing rails. Lineker, can he survive the final 40 seconds in round four?
Lineker just needs a little bit of space, utilize the jab, keep his hands up and get moving. Fabricio's hunting for that knockout.
30 seconds.
Yeah, that cuts right in the corner of the eye there. You can see the blood actually trickling down on his cheek and on Lineker's chest, but it's not impairing the vision, and Herb Dean has a close eye on that, I'm sure.
Uppercut on Andrade. Counter left.
This is Lineker now in the corner. This is kind of a desperation. We're inside the 10-second call here. Once again, he's going to get saved by the bell.
Blood down the face, the nose, and the right side of the face.
Touching him up. Good work by Wonder Boy.
Alex,
seconds out. I'll say this, Rich, for a lot of reasons, but especially the way the first one ended with just kind of a thud. Very disappointing. This one, to me, has lived up to the pinnacle.
Wait a minute, that's it.
That's all. They ended after four rounds.
Lineker didn't answer the call in the fifth round.
Lineker did not answer the bell, and Fabricio Andrade is indeed the world champion in the bantamweight division here in one.
Wow.
Listen, much earned. You know, especially there were two rounds there where Lineker was saved by the bell, particularly in that fourth round there. He was fading. I don't see him coming back from that particular fade at that point in time.
Are you surprised he didn't get off the stool?
Well, I mean, I'll say this, yes, I am, but I don't know what the issue was in the corner. Perhaps he was actually having trouble seeing. And if he can't see, then coming out is just pure stupidity.
Mutual respect for two men that have traded bars, particularly from Andrade, over the last 4 months and leading into the first fight as well.
Yeah, I actually just got word that Alex, his corner man, is the one who stopped the match.
Saving his fighter from himself. We hear it all the time.
That's what your corner men, your doctors, the commissioners, all these people that are involved in these things, that's what they're for. All right, gentlemen, let's go.